One of my professors said to me today that it's just one of those weeks. I couldn't agree more. Something is most definitely in the air, and whatever it is, I am not a fan. It's got me in such a slump, I can't even come up with a witty teaser. At least I know I can always count on LaSalle Sports. Hello, I'm Megan Cooney.
And I'm Charlie Hug. If you think there's a lot going on in your personal life, then wait till you see how much is happening in the world of LaSalle Sports. Playoffs, championship appearances, and a whole lot of updates that you won't want to miss. You're watching LaSalle TV's home for Explore Athletics, Sportsline.
Welcome to Sportsline. We have all of this week's recaps and upcoming games as our Explorers continue to advance in A-10 playoffs.
And later, John Freeman was able to talk to women's soccer coach Paul Royal to talk about their run in the A-10 playoffs, as well as women's basketball coach Mountain McGilvery to give them a preview of their upcoming season.
But first, let's take a look at our Sportsline top three.
Number one, LaSalle Athletics held their annual Thankathon event this week. Over the course of 2 days, LaSalle students athletes made over 800 calls to family, friends, alumni, and donors to thank them for their support.
Number two, single game tickets for the LaSalle basketball season are now on sale. Head to GoExplorers.com to secure your tickets for the men's home opener against Drexel on November 7th and the women's home opener on November 9th. Also, don't miss the chance to buy tickets for the annual homecoming doubleheader on Saturday, November 11th.
Number three, the men's rowing varsity 8-plus boat were named this week's NovaCare Student Athlete Players of the Week. The boat placed third in the head of the Schuylkill race with a time of 11 minutes and 5.29 seconds.
Basketball season. I'm very excited.
We've been looking forward to it for a while, and we finally have some dates set that are coming in our very near future.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to getting the Explorers back out on the court. Basketball season is one of my favorite seasons here at LaSalle. I feel like the spirit and the energy is always here with basketball season. Home opener against Drexel, playing another Big Five school. I feel like the energy and the spirit's going to be there. It should be a really good game, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Absolutely, and homecoming is always one of the best games of the year. Not only do you get one game, you get two of them. You got a whole bunch of alumni back. Everybody's in the spirit. It's the first big games of the year. It's something that's going to be really exciting, and I'm really looking forward to.
Yeah, it's always good to see the alumni come back. LaSalle has such a big alumni and support system behind them, which kind of leads into the Thankathon that I know all the student athletes participated in this week. I always think it's nice that we rely on our alumni, and they're just such big supporters.
And while we're talking about relying on our alumni, the whole Thankathon event, that's exactly what that's made for. A lot of alumni support coming through, especially in just the fall season alone. A lot of these alumni that have played sports and just went here still love to stay involved, and that's a great thing that they can still donate and show their support in any way that they can, which is why I think the Thankathon event is a great event, just to show our appreciation towards all of them.
Yeah, absolutely. That's it for the top three. Now let's see how our teams did in this week's recaps. On Friday, women's field hockey played a tough game against St. Joe's. The Hawks started out strong, getting two goals in the back of the net within the first 10 minutes. Juliana Smythe was able to cut the Hawks' lead in half with her fifth goal of the season. The quarter ended 1-2 with St. Joe's in the lead. Early in the second, the Hawks got another one in, and the half ended with a score of 1-3. The Explorers held off St. Joe's for the third and the fourth quarter, ended with another goal from St. Joe's, ending the game with a 4-1 loss over LaSalle. On Sunday, the Explorers fought hard in their last regular season game against Providence. The Friars struck first in the second quarter, ending the half 1-0. From then on, LaSalle put up a strong defense, only allowing four shots for the rest of the match. At the end of the fourth, Tatum Johnson got one in, and this resulted in a 1-1 tie, leading to overtime. The overtime resulted in no score, leading to a shootout. Emily Strabe was strong in net, only allowing one goal from the Friars. Zao Rodrigo was able to get two goals in leading the Explorers to a 2-1 victory for their last match of the regular season.
The men's soccer team ended their fall season competing against Duquesne. The Explorers took control with an early start and an early lead. Dylan Kwasnik converted on a scoring chance off a feed from senior Drew Blackwell, giving LaSalle a 1-0 lead in the 12th minute. In the 19th minute, the Dukes tied up the game 1-1. LaSalle continued to take control with a 9-7 shot advantage for the first 45 minutes. The score remained tied until Duquesne scored their second goal of the game with just 5 minutes remaining. The Explorers would not find a breakthrough and would fall 2-1.
Last Friday, women's soccer took on Rhode Island in our very own McCarthy Stadium. It would be a neck-and-neck opening half with the Explorers controlling the offensive possessions, outshooting the Rams 5-1, but unable to capitalize on any opportunities. They would continue to control possession in the third half, which would lead to a goal in the 73rd minute by Haley Gestry off a pass from Giovanna Castorano, which would lead to an Explorers 1-0 lead. Just 3 minutes later, Emily Beneshevsky would head in a ball off the double assist from Gestry and Madison McCready to give them a 2-0 lead with 14 minutes left. The Explorers would hold the Rams to just one shot attempt for the rest of the game to knock out the 7th seed Rhode Island and secure themselves a spot in the A-10 semifinals. That game would then be played on Wednesday against the Dayton Flyers. It was even nearly the entire way. No goals would be scored by either team, with the Explorers only having 3 attempts to go wide. It was equally even in the second half, with goalie Michaela Aguadro saving 5 off of the Flyers' 8 attempts as the defense forced the other 3 out of bounds. After 90 minutes of play, the game would head into overtime with the score still tied at 0-0. It would take until the 96th minute of the play before a free kick by Madison McCready would find the head of Kaylee Gestry, who would put it into the net and give the Explorers a 1-0 lead with 4 minutes left in the first overtime. From there, they were able to shut down the Flyers' offense and for the rest of the first and second overtimes, with Aguadro saving 2 more shots, including one in the 106th minute. The Explorers would win the game 1-0, sending them to the Atlantic 10 championship game.
The men's and women's rowing team competed at the head of Schuylkill Regatta on Saturday on the Schuylkill River. The men's team saw all 3 of its boats finish in the top 4 in their respective events. The Explorers' varsity 8-plus boat earned bronze with a time of 11 minutes and 5.9 seconds. The Explorers' 2V8 secured 4th in the men's club 8-plus with a time of 11 minutes and 42.38 seconds. As for the freshman 4-plus boat, finished 4th with a time of 14 minutes and 7.93 seconds. For the women's team, the Explorers' varsity 8-plus and 2nd varsity 8-plus boats placed 9th in their respective events with times of 13 minutes and 30.66 seconds and 13 minutes and 58.40 seconds. This concluded the women's fall season, while the men will travel to New Jersey to compete at the Princeton Chase on November 5th.
The LaSalle cross country team traveled to Ohio over the weekend for the A-10 conference. The men's team had a strong showing at the A-10 conference championships, placing 2nd at the meet. Graduate student Tiango Mbambo, sophomore McCallum Rowe, and junior Andreas Hernandez earned all conference honors after placing 6th, 7th, and 13th respectively. The women's cross-country team fared well at the championship. Graduate student Christine Mancini earned A-10 all-conference honors after placing 14th with a time of 21 minutes and 38.40 seconds. The women's team finished 9th overall in the team standings.
All right, so I think it's time to address the elephant in the room, Megan. We have a championship coming
yes,
up.
Yes, we do. Women's soccer, I am so extremely excited. The game last night was absolutely crazy, and I'm just absolutely over the moon for them. They deserve everything that they got and more.
I was going to say the exact same thing. There's no team that deserves this more than them, especially they started their season. We've mentioned it before. It was a little rocky, but to come and not lose for 11 straight games, I think it is now, they were nine wins and one tie. Now they've won 2 in the playoffs, and one was huge last night that we saw, keeping a Davidson team that was 13-1 coming into the game to 0 goals in the entire game is amazing. Michaela Aguadro, who we've talked about more than enough on the show, has done so much this season. Another clean slate. She looked amazing, and to bring it to overtime and still compete at that high of a level, it was really an impressive game to watch.
It was, and I know we constantly talk about the players and their sense of unity, and just the individual talent alone on that team is so amazing that I feel like when you put them all together, that's where they really shine. Right before the show started, they released the A-10 all-conference teams, and Haley Gestry and Rashae Walker were both named to it this year, and I think that that's absolutely well-deserved. We talk about those names, like you said, well enough on this show, and I feel like it was absolutely their season and their time to shine. Haley Gestry had 8 goals, 16 points, 45 shots, and 18 shots on goal all season. She was the tying, Rashae Walker also was tying for the team lead in shots, and so I feel like both of them together are just absolutely, they bring this team together, and the whole entire team atmosphere is just absolutely phenomenal.
Definitely, yeah. The seniors on this team have really been stepping up, as you just mentioned. Those two, and then Madison McCready getting her fifth assist last night on what was the game-winning goal and the only goal of the game. That brought her to five assists on the season. It's just these seniors are really getting their moment, and it's the first time that they've been in a championship game. I'm really happy to see all of them get this time to shine, and as well as the rest of the team. And I'm really excited to see how that game goes. Win or lose, I think this is one of the most successful seasons that we've seen in a long time.
Absolutely. I also want to switch gears to field hockey real quick. Field hockey season did indeed end today. They lost 4-0 to St. Joe's. But I feel like they're another team that really stood out this year. Making it to A-10s in the beginning was absolutely phenomenal. They had such a team atmosphere, and I feel like they definitely deserved. They had the most wins, 13-5 was their record this year, since 1981. That's going back a lot of years. Like, they were the most, like, I don't know. They just have such an energy about them, and I feel like it was really well-deserved. It was a great season for them, and so I'm very, very proud.
Absolutely. And I mean, they may have lost their only playoff game, but in a sport like that, they only had four playoff teams. Mm-hmm. And so to make it is an accomplishment on its own. And St. Joe's, this will be their first time in, I think, over a decade that they have been in the playoffs, or and maybe even the championship game. They have been a powerhouse in the A-10 field hockey scene, and so playing against them, it's a tough team to beat, but I think they put on a great effort, and to make the playoffs, they had an amazing season, and that's nothing that they should be upset about.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we'll get to hear what Coach Royal had to say about the women's soccer season. Stay tuned.
Mental and substance use disorders can put the strength of family and community behind you. We're all connected, offering encouragement, support, and hope. Join the Voices for Recovery. Strengthen families and communities.
Think buying fake products is harmless? Think again. Think fake cosmetics are tested and safe? Think again. Think that medicine you can buy off social media is high quality? Think again. Counterfeits are made in unsafe conditions, potentially using hazardous and even lethal ingredients that could harm you and others. Each year, billions of dollars worth of counterfeit products are sold in the U.S. I smell big crime. Think about it. If you don't know where the products came from, how could you know where the money goes? You're smart. Buy smart. Go for real.
Unused prescription opioid pain medicines can spell risk if they're taken by someone they weren't prescribed for, or harm if accidentally taken by a child or a pet. Safely dispose of opioids before they can hurt your family. Find a drug take-back option such as medicine drop-off boxes. If there isn't one available, check the FDA's flush list. If your medicine isn't on the flush list, you can dispose of it in the trash. Get information to keep your family safe.
Welcome back. Let's hear what John Freeman and Coach Royal had to say about the women's soccer team run in the A-10 playoffs. Take a look.
Coach Royal, congratulations on your A-10 semi-conference final win. I mean, how are you feeling? How are the girls feeling?
Oh, it's unbelievable. It really is. You know, I think it just shows how determined this group is. You know, I thought a lot of parts of the game, Dayton had a real good grip of it, mm-hmm. but our girls just kept battling. Something that they've done all season, even when we were losing games early on, they were battling. I couldn't be more proud of this group. The seniors really led the charge. And it was an unbelievable victory for us.
Coach, what did you tell the girls going into that second overtime and even the first one as well?
I think really just, you know, keep our pressure going, but try and bit and relax and really compose ourselves to make the passes. Thought we could get behind them and have some success. It turned out to be a set piece that, you know, Haley had a great finish from Madison's cross. But it was meant to be for this group. It really was. So we're really excited about the final.
Coach, how much better will this team have to be moving forward? I know you mentioned that you'll be playing St. Louis, one of the formidable teams in the conference, a team that hasn't lost a game in this conference. But you've been there. Some of the girls that are playing tonight and have played tonight have been there. How much better will this team have to be moving forward in order to clinch that victory and become A-10 champions?
Yeah, we'll have to play at our best, you know, but we know we had it. You know, I thought we did in the quarterfinal, and I thought we did in a lot of parts of that second half. I think it really comes down to, you know, our energy, the commitment that they're willing to put in from a work rate level, and it's going to be a tough challenge, especially being at their home. But, you know, I thought we played them well in the first game. They had a couple moments that were really brilliant, but these girls have done everything. Everything we've asked of them, so I'm expecting them to do even more.
Coach, there's a little bit of a layover period. You have a few days to rest before you head down to Missouri. What specifically will you tell the girls in order to, you know, just to keep their minds right and to keep them focused? You know, they have classes, you know, they'll be around friends. What will you tell them to be focused in order to be prepared for this match?
You know, it's something that we've been saying all season is living in a moment. You know, we're not looking too far ahead. We're going to obviously get some recovery and regeneration tomorrow. Especially after a lot of players logged, you know, the whole 110 minutes, I think it was, for them. And, you know, it really just stick with what we've been doing, you know, because the girls have been battling and we've been defending as well as any team in the country right now. So if we keep doing that, you know, we're going to frustrate anybody.
Awesome, Coach. Coach Rowe, I thank you so much for taking the time talking to me tonight. I mean, I've been covering your team for so long. I really appreciate everything you've done with the program. I wish you the best of luck down in Missouri. Really appreciate you, man.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Take care.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Shout out to Sportsline reporter John Freeman for doing that. What an amazing, amazing time to be there in the moment to catch that action as it happened. Coach Royal is just such an amazing person, and actually right before we went live, he was named the A-10 Coach of the Year, so congratulations to him. He's led the Explorers in 8-1-1 play in A-10 Conference, and so he just really, really deserves it. Fifth A-10 championship in program history, so congratulations to him.
I was going to say, after watching that interview, there's no question why he brings such a great culture to this team. He's such a positive attitude, especially, I mean, after a win like that, everyone's going to be positive. But even going into a game where they have a very strong opponent against St. Louis, who just won their last matchup 5-0, they beat us 4-0 earlier in the season. It's going to be a tough matchup, and you can tell he's positive, the girls are going to be positive, and it's going to be a great game to watch. So now let's take a preview of the women's basketball upcoming season from another interview by John Freeman.
Coach McGilvery, pleasure to meet you today. Just a couple questions about the upcoming season. You've seen this team in practice. They've been working hard. You were preaching to them today about staying on top of things and just being thorough defensively. About their efforts this season, what is something that you can expect from them overall?
Yeah, the intensity and the effort and the pace that they've been playing with it's really fun to watch. I mean, they really have been going hard, competing on every possession, and looking forward to see how that translates into games.
Definitely, definitely. Molly was a transfer. Molly Maciantiano was a transfer coming into LaSalle. You've done well to integrate transfer players into your squad in past years. How do you plan to integrate all the transfers that you received this year into this year's squad?
You know, a lot of it goes into the recruiting process. It's, you know, who we bring in, right? We're not just looking for just anybody. And this group of players came here from day one with a, you know, a little bit of a chip on their shoulder. They wanted to prove they belong. They also, you know, wanted to be part of something where everybody was supporting one another and being great teammates, and they bought into that from day one, and it's been an easy transition. We haven't had to do much special. It's really them.
Definitely. Coach, early on in the season, you guys will have some competitive out-of-conference games. You'll be playing in 12 days against Coppin State in Baltimore in Maryland, and then in addition, you'll be playing teams like Maine and American University at home. How important are those non-conference games, not only for you but for your team?
Yeah, they're huge. I mean, they are us. Well, first off, every game counts, right? They go right on your record. But we're also, you know, trying to figure out who we're going to be and what we're made of. And right away, Coppin's going to be a great test. We go on the road for game one. We haven't had a ton of success in our openers. So it'll be interesting to see how we come out the gate this time.
Definitely. Coach, what do you expect from Explorers fans this year? I know last year you received a lot of support at home games. What is something that you really expect from people who support your team and your program overall?
Well, you know, I think, you know, what our fans can expect is us to be play an exciting brand of basketball. And from that, I want them to spread the word and bring more people out to the gym to make this place noisy and loud and give our players some energy. I think our players are going to give the fans a boost by the way they play. It'd be nice late in games when we're a little tired that those fans are here giving us a boost.
Definitely, Coach. Coach, you also mentioned throughout practice that you didn't really care about, you know, the success in defensive plays particularly, but you more so cared about the effort that was there. Effort is something that you reiterated time and time again throughout practices. How important will effort be throughout the season in non-conference games and in conference games in the A-10?
You know, it's crucial. Like, the team that wants it the most is typically the team that goes out there and gets it. And, you know, part of us is, a lot of new faces, a lot of kids coming into new roles. It's them figuring out the defensive schemes and how to play it. That's not going to be perfect early. What can be perfect is how hard we go.
Awesome, Coach. And your assistant coach, Chris Day, he's been helping you a lot. He's been there. He was really present today in practice. How important is your relationship with him and just his role in the program right now?
You know, I've been blessed with a fantastic staff, you know, starting with Coach Day and his tremendous experience. You know, he's been, you know, a friend and a mentor to me, you know, my time in this business, and to have him working alongside of me is amazing. And, you know, Coach Boo has been here from the beginning. She does a fantastic job working with our guards of, you know, picking out things in our opponent that we need to attack, of recruiting and helping identify these athletes. And Jaren was on our first team, and she knows what it means to be an explorer and where she wants this place to go. I've been really fortunate to have this crew with me.
Awesome. Last question, Coach. You're entering your sixth season, if I'm correct.
Yes.
Your sixth season at LaSalle. What are some things, not that you just expect, but that you hope for from your players and from other people that support your program? Again, a comprehensive question, but very important. You had some experience with the program for 6 years, so just looking back on all the years you've been with LaSalle, what is something that you can just say or that you really, you know, want to happen for the sixth year?
Listen, I want continued growth. Like, each year we've gotten better and better. This year, you know, we graduated a lot last year, so there's going to be, you know, a learning curve. But I'm excited by the group that's on the floor, the way they're competing, the way they're supporting one another, and just to see that translate into on-court success. And that's going to stir up more interest in the public and the fans and the support from the alumni, and to continue to push that, that growing snowball, right? You know, hopefully gets bigger and bigger, and special things happen then.
Definitely. Thank you so much, Coach Mountain. I really appreciate meeting you today, and I wish you the best of luck in your home opener.
My pleasure.
And I just, again, wish you the best of luck. Hope you really do well against Coffin State as well.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.
So once again, I just want to thank John for that. No better time than right before the season. So that's a great preview, and it's something that another thing, like we said earlier, really looking forward to. Molly Massantonio, who they mentioned in the interview, we're looking for another great season out of her. She has not had a season where she's averaged under 6 points yet. She's always been one of the biggest focal points of this team, mm-hmm. And now she has the spot to be the leader in her senior season. So that's something that's definitely going to be worth keeping an eye on. I'm sure we're going to mention her name a lot more coming up in these episodes.
Yeah, absolutely. And I know that women's basketball always, I feel like there is a big support and there's a big crowd around it, but I always feel like sometimes it does get overlooked a little bit because of all the hype surrounding men's basketball. But I just want to point out, like, women's basketball had a winning season last year. Like, they went to playoffs. And so I feel like it's always very important to mention them. They have a great team. So just making sure that this season, like, I'm sure we're going to talk so much about it. Like I said, basketball season is my favorite time of the year. But just keeping them in the back of our minds, because I feel like sometimes they get pushed to the back because of men's basketball and they get a little bit overlooked. So.
Definitely.
We're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we'll have all of the upcoming sports from this week. Stay tuned.
Did you know that listening to music, enjoying art, or simply holding hands can boost your cognition? Trying new foods, making friends, and being curious helps too. Just like me, you want to maintain your brain health for as long as possible. I'd like to share with you insights that can make a difference. I'm Kevin Jameson, president of the Dementia Society of America. I'm excited to offer you our free guide. Inside, you'll find 10 building blocks to better brain health, along with facts about dementia, care planning, and how experts make a diagnosis. You'll learn what dementia is and isn't. The Dementia Society of America is a nonprofit organization, and we are ready to answer your questions. Get your free copy of the guide by visiting 1-800-DEMENTIA.org or by calling 1-800-DEMENTIA. You want to live life to the fullest? I do too, and I'm confident that our free guide can help.
Welcome back. We've got another week of LaSalle sports coming up, so here's what you have to look forward to. Swimming and diving takes on Villanova on Saturday at 10 a.m. at Villanova. Women's soccer has officially advanced to the Atlantic 10 Championship and will now play St. Louis on Sunday, November 5th at noon.
Men's and women's basketball will both open their seasons this week, with the women's team kicking off the season with a matchup against Coppin State on Monday before the men's team takes on Big Five opponent Drexel on Tuesday.
All right, I feel like we have kind of covered everything, yes. But I feel like I can't cover basketball enough.
We're a little excited about the future. We've talked about it a lot.
We are. Well, we have exciting things coming up. Like I said, the beginning of basketball season is always such a fun time here at LaSalle. We have that Big Five opener for the men against Drexel, and then we have the doubleheader on homecoming, and so I feel like that's always just something that gets the energy really up. We have a lot of good things to look forward to with basketball. We have the two star guards coming back, Burkus and Brantley. I'm really, really excited to see them. I know I kind of touched on it last show, but they just have such a dynamic and they work together so well. There was an article released a couple days ago talking about them and being back on the court and having that dynamic. And I feel like they just always show up, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah, definitely. And then if you add Deshaun Shepard in there too, just the energy that all three of them bring. I remember someone mentioning Deshaun Shepard as the best dunker in the A-10, and I would have to agree with them on that one. So that's always fun to watch. Definitely excited for that. And then, once again, I think we'll all be glued to our TVs at about noon on Sunday. Mm-hmm. So I think we're ready for these upcoming games.
Yeah, so good luck to women's soccer. We're all here for you. And that just about wraps it up for this week. If you can't make it out to see the Explorers play, be sure to tune in next week for our coverage. Keep up with this weekend's other sporting events by visiting GoExplorers.com.
Also, check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/LaSalleTV and on Instagram at SportslineLTV. We welcome you to send us your thoughts and suggestions there.
From all of us here at Sportsline, I'm Megan Cooney.
And I'm Charlie Hugg. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you at the game.